Well, hello, Andy Bassist coming at you once again. This week we've got the Shank from Lateral Sound. It's a drive distortion pedal. It's got a pretty simple control out. So yeah, across the top you've got level, high, mid, low. You've got your gain, and then you've got your edge control. So yeah, let's just take you through some sounds. We're going to be going straight into my OB1 500 from Orange, and then we'll switch and go into my Rockaverb, and then we'll do both together. As always, more is more. So yeah, let's get into some sounds. So we've sort of gone around the Recon a little bit. What I'd like to show for just a second is how this pedal interacts with other drives for like stacking and whatnot. For those of the really like high gain, high distortion sort of bass sounds. So what I have is perfectly, I would say, is a Fuzz Roses Bong Gripper V2. It's the one with the added boost, basically, if anybody has seen my board before. I will put a little demo clip up top. And basically what I'm going to do is put this, have a clean sound, then bring the bong gripper in, and then put the shank on top. It is excessive. It is too much. But as I said before, more is always more. Okay, now, and just for fun, just for a little something different, because it's a lateral sound pedal, it works really well with other lateral sound pedals. Now, I'm lucky enough to have a Brute. Not everyone is, like, it's not released at all. He sent it to me for a demo and never got it back. So what I'm going to do is we'll go clean, Brute, and then the Shank. As I said, that is a bit much for some. It's quite a lot of top end going on, but I find that if you're in a band with distorted guitars, that really allows the bass to cut right through. Not all sounds sound incredible on their own. Some need a band context. I'm working on a demo with that where I'm going to have sort of a full band playing, so you can kind of hear the sounds of my board with in the context of a band. So, yeah. But anyway, no one wants to hear that. You're all very bored and you want to hear sounds. So, let's do the rockaverb, shall we? Let's play into the rockaverb. Okay, so I've muted the Obi-Wan 500. This is just the pure rockaverb 100 Mark III. Bit of reverb. It's into the dirty channel, it's our full 100 watts. It's what you're hearing is the feed from a two-note torpedo captor. So yeah, sounds pretty sick. I'm not going to bother with a clean channel, I'm really sorry, but I don't use it, as sacrilege that is. I use it as a big old distortion pedal, so it is literally gained up all the time. It's attenuated a bit, but not a lot. But yeah, it's nice and crunchy, and yeah, so here's the Shank into the front of that. So yeah, that signal into the rockaverb. I could mess around with the EQ a bit more. I'm not sure how interested some of you are. If you are and you'd like to hear more sounds of stuff going into the rockaverb, please let me know, and I will of course oblige. Okay, so now there's only really one thing left to do, and that's to play both amps. With a bit of distortion. What I'm going to do is I'm probably going to use the Brute sound, so you can hear that it's quite full on, and yeah, so enjoy. I'll do one where it's a clean Obi-Wan 500 with the Shank underneath the rockaverb, and then we'll have, well, not underneath, they're more 50-50, but have one, like I say, where you've got a clean Obi-Wan 500 with the Shank onto it, and then I'll do one where you've got the dirty Obi-Wan 500 with the Brute. And yeah, we'll go down that route.